Hello, Cancer. Welcome to January and 2018. This is Gwendolyn. Welcome back to the channel. Or if it's your first time here, welcome. This video is going to be a monthly tarot for Cancer for January. And I just want to wish everyone a wonderful start to the new year. You're kind of featured with this, Cancer, because we open the month with this beautiful full moon in your sign, and it's happening in your first house of the self and your identity. And so the spotlight's on you, Cancer. There's also a grand trine in water, so that full moon in Cancer, which is your ruling planet, by the way, is trining Neptune in Pisces, which is Pisces' ruling planet. And then we have Mars and Jupiter in Scorpio. So all this watery, poetic, dreamy energy. It's been a beautiful full moon. I'm recording this right around that time. So it's like the spotlight is on you, Cancer, here with this full moon in your first house. And something regarding yourself, you may be coming to a point of feeling like you've arrived at something, feeling a sense of completion, feeling like the spotlight is on you. We've got Jupiter expanding things in your fifth house of romance and true love, and Mars is there activating it in terms of vitality and energy and passion as well. And then Neptune is in Pisces, which is in your ninth house of higher learning and spirituality and travel. So it's just, I'm just going to say lap it up, Cancer. It's kind of all about you in terms of this full moon. And it's just going to be very, very sweet for you. So that's going on at the beginning of the month. Then in the middle of the month, on January 16th, we have a new moon in your seventh house, more romantic energy. This is in your seventh house of partnerships. So some of you may have a new person coming in, a new partner, or if you're already in partnership, it could be like a new phase of your relationship is beginning. New moons are opportunity to plant new seeds, to set new intentions, and to begin new things. So right around mid-month, January 16th, is a good time to begin something new in terms of your partnership or your involvement with partnership. So if you're in a relationship, it may be taking things to the next level or going to a new place, new cycle with your current partner. Or for those of you who are single, it may be a new person showing up with all this energy, you know, expansion and blessings in your fifth house of true love and romance, and with the moon, the emotional planet, in your first house of self. The moon will have moved by then, but at the beginning of the month, it's setting quite a tone where the spotlight is on you, Cancer. So lots of really good stuff. And whatever you begin right around January 16th, you know, you may see some nice results by the full moon in Cancer right around your birthday, 6 months from now. So set that intention or begin that regarding partnerships or relationships and watch that grow over the next 6 months, Cancer. Really beautiful time for all you Cancers. And then at the end of the month, we have a second full moon on January 31st. That is considered a blue moon because whenever you get two full moons in 1 month, that second full moon is considered a blue moon. So let's see what's coming up for Cancer for January in the cards. Looks like we have you. This is the water sign, so it could also be Pisces or Scorpio, but I'm reading this as you, Cancer. Maybe, you know, there's success showing up here with you, that you're looking at success, but it's in reverse. So it's saying that there's some way in which there's fear, doubt, or resistance to you experiencing success and victory and status and reputation. And what I'm wondering is, what the question that it brings up for me is, what is What fear, doubt, or resistance is there to you feeling like you can be perceived as the person on the horse? You know, the person who walks in and saves the day, the victor. This is the victory laurel of success. It's given to those who are in a competition who win the game, like in the Olympics. The traditional prize was a victory laurel wreath. So I'm seeing this as you, Cancer. And I'm seeing this card, Six of Wands, success in reverse. What doubt, fear, resistance is there in terms of you experiencing success, status, reputation, victory? It's almost as though it's sort of the reverse of the Emperor wearing new clothes. Sometimes when I see this card, it can be on the low side. It can be the Emperor's wearing no clothes, where the kid says, you know, that person is being celebrated, but there's really not, they're not wearing any clothes. Like, nobody's acknowledging that. And I'm almost going to say the reverse is like, in some ways, you've arrived, Cancer. You've made it. In what way are you not acknowledging that? Like, if you take a look around, you may see that you're sitting pretty. You've arrived and you've achieved quite a bit. And this spotlight is on you. And it's almost just a matter of saying, yes, looking at yourself and saying, yes, I have arrived. I am experiencing wonderful things. So I'm going to say the best energy for the opening of January is a feeling of gratitude and just acknowledging what it is that you have achieved, you know, acknowledging yourself as this person on the horse, Cancer. So that's all I'm seeing here. They're both very positive cards. This is the nurturing, intuitive, emotional queen, and this is success. So it's sort of like, this is you, and this is success, victory, acclaim, pride, status, reputation, all that good stuff. So embrace it, allow it, recognize it, and acknowledge it. That's really your task. And I think if you take a look around and acknowledge the gratitude for what you have, you may realize that you're here. It's just a matter of seeing that that's where you're at, Cancer. I do see someone who's behaving less than nobly. This is Seven of Swords. And sometimes this is like me, me, me behavior. It might be regarding a partner. This is Two of Cups in reverse. So feeling like someone's being potentially a little selfish, or that someone has cut out on their own. But I don't necessarily see this as being a threat. The only way that it can affect the situation is if you see it as undermining your success, Cancer. Because these are all in reverse. And there is a person here who is acting either selfishly or deceptively or getting theirs at the expense of anything else. But even so, I mean, some people might read this as you being out of order, no success, and no relationship. However, I see it as these cards are here. I always see reverse cards as the energy showing up, and that there's only fear, doubt, or resistance that is putting them in delay or putting them in shadows. So I see all good stuff here. I'm going to say that if your focus is on anyone who's acting like this, maybe it's an employee, maybe it's a friend, maybe it's whomever, someone in your environment. If the focus is on them and their actions, then you kind of lose all the vibrant color that is in all these things. They all go upside down. But if you keep your focus here on you and your success and your relationship, look at all the good stuff that's here, Cancer. I mean, it's basically you, success, and relationship. It's all that beautiful trine water energy. And it's victorious. It's celebrated. So my message to you for the beginning of January, Cancer, is to not let anyone else steal your thunder. Not let anyone else become the focus that drains you from everywhere that you are and everything that you've achieved and all the love that is surrounding you. Don't let them steal that away from you, because you have the power to do that. So that's my reading of those, the opening cards for January. Then it looks like we've got Two of Wands and Magician, Nine of Swords, and Knight of Swords. So what this tells me is that you just need to keep your thoughts in check, because you have the capability to create anything you want. This is Magician. Magician says abracadabra. There, I say it is, therefore it is so. And Two of Wands is your personal power and your courage and boldness. You're having a vision and implementing it. And by the way, you're receiving help with that, Cancer. You're holding that pearl. This card here is draped in pearls, which is very much related to Cancerian symbols, like the moon, moonstone, pearlescence. There's something that is very related between pearls and Cancer. So I want you to see this as like the world is your oyster. The world is in the palm of your hands. You just need to have the confidence to believe it. Don't let worries or overthinking, as symbolized by this Nine of Swords, drain anything away from you. This is really, really what I'm getting. See how these cards are in the upright? There's strength to them because they're showing up upright. And it's what it's doing is it's turning all this good stuff upside down. So don't let this become your focus. This is anguish, overthinking, staying too much in your mind. You'll see that these are swords cards, and so is this. These are the only upright cards so far, Cancer. So what it's telling me is that your mind may be taking over the show. I want you to get closer to your heart. Water energy, that's who you are. Remember, Queen of Cups. Or King of, you know, whether you're male or female, Queen of Cups symbolizes you, Cancer. So, and that's where you shine. That's where that illuminated moon, that full moon, your planet, really shows up, is in the emotional sphere. So don't let overthinking or someone else's thoughts or criticism or harsh words take you out, especially regarding relationships. You have all the power, Cancer. You're Magician, you're Two of Wands, you're Six of Wands, you're Queen of Cups. This is all you. All fantastic, powerful, capable. I mean, look, here's what I just want to show you the three cards that are surrounding you, Cancer, for January. Look at this. Two of Wands, boldness, vision, making fire, world in the palm of your hands, capability. Magician creates anything he wants or she wants. Manifester. Magic. Six of Wands, success, victory, triumph, acclaim. You know, these are what's surrounding you in January. The only reason they're all upside down is because there's some sort of fear, doubt, or resistance. You may be listening too much to worrisome thoughts or actions, behavior, thoughts of someone else. Thoughts are words. That's what Swords energy is about. Get out of your head and get back into your heart, and all the stuff flips back around. So there may be an air sign who may be helpful to, if you are experiencing any of this, like anguish or agony over someone's bad behavior, you know, talk to this air sign person, this Libra, Aquarius, or Gemini, because they're on your side. They're a knight that will go into the fire for you. This could be your partner, or a family member, a friend, whoever it is that's in your environment. Very likely air sign. But there's, allow them to be your knight in shining armor. I mean, allow them to go into whatever fiery towers are showing up for you, you know, especially as related to the mind, because this is their element. This is what they know how to deal with. They'll be able to clear all this up for you. Especially if it involves indecision of any kind around that new moon, around mid-month. If you don't know which way to go, whether to go left or right, ask an air sign. They'll know. They'll be able to sort that out for you. You may be experiencing some confusion. I'm seeing dilemma here between Two of Swords and then, you know, the passionate wild side and then logical, practical, analytical side. You may be having a real pull in January between head and heart. I'm going to say go into your heart. Your heart knows. You know, the moon, this full moon is showing up for you again. I'm getting this is that second full moon. By trusting your feelings, here's that crab. That's what takes you forward. You may have to do things in an unconventional way. You Cancerians are usually okay with that. And Three of Swords, there's some thought, again, the Swords energy, that you're going to need to release in order to heal your heart. There's some sort of heartbreak, betrayal, disappointment in someone not acting in a way that is honorable. And it's really on your mind this month. You really are having a hard time reconciling that, Cancer. But again, your heart is what knows. Your heart is where you experience all this great strength. Your mind may be, you may be of two minds this month. So, Swords energy, if there's an overabundance of that, this is what happens. You go into, anxiety, tension, or stress, if there's an overabundance of Swords energy. So, what I want to encourage you to do is go into the other elements. Go into water energy, which is your ruling energy, which means going into your heart and your emotions. Or earth energy, which will stabilize and ground you. Maybe meditation, working, you know, being in nature. Or fire energy is also really good for you right now, being active, exercising, being passionate. All that kind of stuff is going to help you this month because right now, with all this Swords energy, I'm just getting that being in your head might trip you up this month. You're really going to have a lot better time if you go into your heart and you listen to what's going on there. You're surrounded by good things, Cancer. So let your heart guide you this month. There's all this water energy in the sky as well, so it's your natural element. Go swim in the sea of emotion. That's really where your strength is and where you show up and what takes you forward and out of confusion. So that's my reading for you, Cancer, for January. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, feel free to give it a thumbs up or share it with another Cancer who you think might enjoy it. As always, if you want to book a personal reading with me, you can do that. I'll have my email down below. And I just want to thank everyone so much for watching. Yours in the stars.